Blender is an amazing tool for creativity, which allows you to create everything and use it for free. And one of the most powerful tools in Blender is geometry nodes. This tool indeed can expand your skill set. Now you may see this Blender scene and this terrain, but by default it's simple plane. And these landscape details are created with geometry nodes in a Blender and using procedural method. That means I can easily make changes in this landscape and get another terrain. Alright, how to create a large landscape using geometry node in a Blender? So let's start with simple plan. I open geometry nodes and delete this frame, we don't need it anymore. Also timeline and press new. I need a huge plan for my landscape. If we look at the final render, it's pretty large terrain, so I scale this plan. If you also have some problem like this, when the object is cutting off with viewport, increase clip and to something like 5000, and now the whole object is visible in the viewport. Let's begin with the noise texture. Exactly the noise texture will give us to create a landscape, but we need somehow to connect this noise texture with the main geometry. To do this, we may use the set position node, which I put it between group input and output. Now we can use this noise texture as information for offset for this set position node. Also, we need to subdivide geometry to increase density and see results more clearly. To do this, I have to go to edit mode, and I would use subdivide to do this, but I want to create square polygons of equal size. But since the plane is not a rectangle, it's not possible. Therefore, I'm going to use a cut loop to subdivide the plane and set the necessary numbers of edges. This method will be good for displacement. Alright, but our landscape still doesn't look like a terrain. Because the position works in all axes, we need to say to Blender that I want to use this noise texture only on Z axis. For that, I need combine XYZ node, connect noise texture to Z and offset in the set position node. Now we need a math node to put it between noise texture and combine XYZ and change to multiply. Using this node, I can impact the strings of displacement and the height of the landscape. Remove normalize and let's configure noise texture so that this look like landscape. There is still not enough grid density, so I'm going to add subdivide mesh right behind the group input, and I can subdivide the plane in the geometry node. Okay, I leave 2 for now, but in the final render I will use 4 to get good quality of terrain. So now it looks like noise displacement, and I add RGB curve node after noise texture. This allows me to set the range of this noise and create mountains and hills. See how it works. I'm changing the curve and it gives different variation of landscape, so I can use RGB curve to recreate different combination impact in the terrain by adding more mountains or making it flatter. Alright, this is noise setup, but I wanna add another noise for large terrain shape, and this one will be detailed for this terrain. I add mass grave texture and connect instead for this noise texture. I duplicate this mass node because I also need a settings of scale, but it must be small value just to make it uneven surface. Some kind of like this. So now we have this noise and mass grave nodes. and we need to combine everything into one. To combine this, we need a vector math node. To see what happened here, I disconnect this one and connect again. See the difference. As this one creates main terrain noise and this one creates details. So, this pretty simple geometry node that can help to create different landscapes in Blender just using noise texture settings, I already can adjust the terrain. For the final render, I set subdivision mesh 4 and we see more details appeared on the surface. Looks good, and the next step we need to create a material for this surface. If you look at this scene, it's a smart material that consists of two materials, rock and sand, but these two materials are mixed depending on the height of the landscape. The highest part is a rock and lower part is a sand. So how to make this effect? I open the shader editor here and add new material. Let's name it. It's necessary to set material in geometry node. I find the same node and connect it to the main geometry node line. And here we may see that material which we just created. Alright, now this plane has a material and I first add textures here. I believe it's so simple, so we can go to the interesting part. How to create a mask based on the height of the object. To do this, we need to get information about Z axis of this object and use this information. In the shader editor, we have an opportunity to use geometry node, which can give this information. Here we may find the position, but this position has information about all axes. So we need to use a separate XYZ node to extract information from Z axis only. If I connect Z to the material output, we may see what it looks like. This is what we need. Remains only mix two shader and use this as a mask. Connect this material to the mix shader node and use this information as a mask. We just need to invert this material. Also, we can use a color ramp with this mask to make it softer or change the range. And we must do the same for displacement, just using a mix color node instead. So this is a mask to mix two different materials based on the information from height of the Z axis. You're welcome to access this geometry nodes landscape by downloading it from my Patreon page. I've created a customizable setup for easy integration into your other projects. Simply follow the link provided in the description to get this geometry nodes setup for your project.